RX 7800 XT. What is up, y'all? This is Alex from Alex PC Tech, back at you with another video, and today we are going to take a look at the two variants, which is the XFX Speedster QICK 3197800 XT and the MERC 3197800 XT Black. First of all, we would like to clarify that this is not a versus video, but rather give you two options for cooling. Now that we have that out of the way, the ones that we have here are from XFX or Extreme FX, and if you haven't heard about them, they are one of the best custom board partners of Team Red, and they have been manufacturing AMD-only graphics cards since 2009. The 7800 XTs that we have here are from the Speedster series, the MERC and the QICK editions respectively. Both of them have a 3 ball bearing fan setup, two 100mm and one 90mm, thus the 319. They both have the same custom PCB board, but that's where the similarities end. From the get-go, you can see that the MERC edition has more girth, as you need to allocate 2.75 card slots compared to the QICK edition that only has 2.5 card slot. The MERC has a 32.6 length as well, and this is due to the fact that the MERC edition is focused on cooling, and the QICK edition, I'm guessing, will be the base starting model for the 7800 XT for this brand. But don't disregard the 7800 XT, as this card still almost has the same design as the previous 6800 XT, and no doubt that it will still be cool under normal gaming workloads. Going back to the 7800 XT MERC edition, up front the shroud is aluminum and the XFX logo lights up in white, so it does not have this blackout theme compared to the QICK one. Moving on to the backplate, both of them are aluminum. However, they went with a thicker, almost double the height, die-casted aluminum on the MERC, and we don't know if this feature promises to be more thermal conductive than a standard aluminum found on the QICK. But we do know that the thicker backplate will dissipate heat better. Both of these cards also have the same 6mm 5-piece copper inside, however, the total length of the heat pipes for the MERC edition is 30% more than the QICK, as the MERC has an additional vapor chamber, which is a design unique to the MERC, as it claims to efficiently transfer heat from the GPU and VRAM to the heat pipes, and this explains the higher card slot requirement for the 7800 XT MERC. Having all of these information, we can assume that the 7800 XT MERC is geared towards overclocking, as it can handle more heat and the dedicated power phases increase from 8 out of 14 phases on the 7800 XT QICK to 9 out of 14 on the 7800 XT MERC edition. For the GPU FX core, and both of these feature a digital PWM. We'll discuss on that maybe on a separate video, but for now, some notable features of this card are smart silent cooling technology, the digital PWM that we previously mentioned, XFX's ghost thermal design, dual BIOS, and a 3-year limited warranty courtesy of the manufacturer. Also, let's not forget RDNA 3 and how that plays out on this card's cooling design. That's it for this video. Like if you like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't subscribed yet. And yeah, what do you think? Does the extra heat dissipation justify the price difference between these two models? Let us know down in the comments below, and see you on the next one.